There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing. Everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere can you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bath. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you opened, and there you are. Next day on your dressing room, they hung a star. Let's go on with the show.
What shooting match you talking about?
Train Frank Butler in your best local shot.
Rookie admission, this is my hotel. See that sign up there? It says Wilson. I'm Wilson. This is off of my lawn and you ain't on no damn shooting match,
are you? Well, this is your lucky day, Mr. Wilson, because we're also going to be booking sand in your best room.
You out of your head? That's that Piney Bill and his boy Eastro stayed here. And all they did was chase women up and down my stairs and on horseback.
Our folks would never dream of doing that. Thanks to your refund. Thanks to you and on your backstage. Come on, Mr. Wilson, what have you got to lose?
Spoons, towels, bad mats, salt shakers, whatever ain't nailed down. The last time, mister, get off of my lawn.
Mr. Wilson. You ignorant creature!
loaded?
Sure is. But I hit you! I'm just fooling. Buzzard ain't in season. Feller down the road, he told me I'm about to deal with some business here.
What kind of business you got?
Well, I got quails, ducks, grouses, geese, squirrels, possums, wild turkeys, rabbits.
Now I got all the game I need.
Sure you do, but when people eat the game you got, they'll be spitting buckshot out all over your floor. Their teeth too popular.
Learning, still there.
Say, how would you like to make 10? Make that $5.
Doing what?
As this big swollen head is dipping while
we're... Lord, no! I don't shoot people!
No. Just challenge anybody to a shooting match.
Where is he? I can shoot anything he can shoot, and I can do it standing on my head singing Swanee River.
Now, I gotta warn you, you won't get nothing if you lose.
Lose? That's a good one, mister. I can't lose.
I'll be right back. Say, what's your name?
Annie. Annie Oakley.
Don't go anywhere, Annie Oakley.
You get your notes so dirty.
What's that you got there, girl?
What's it look like?
I don't know. Beats the hell out of me. Could be anything. Don't suppose it's a rifle, is it?
Ain't you got eyes? Yeah, you got eyes.
Let me see you a minute. You shouldn't be fooling around with an old piece of junk like this. You know that, don't you? You been locked in the damn thing you exploded in your face and blew your ears off, would you? You just go on and get us back to your pappy and get yourself a nice pair of mint deals, you hear? So long, honey.
Hey, miss, you don't reckon if you stay to keep for a couple hours more, do you?
Don't make no difference to me, just don't want you to hurt yourself, that's all.
Oh, I just gotta win this shooting contest off of this big, swollen-headed stiff from the Wild West Show.
You talking about Frank Butler?
Oh, they didn't give me no names. They just said he was this big, swollen-headed stiff.
Yeah, I heard that part, too. Did they also mention that he's a... champagne.
What's that?
A champagne means he's the best.
He was?
Yeah, well, Frank Butler wouldn't shoot against no girl.
He's got to. He challenged anybody, and I'm anybody. Besides, I don't shoot like no girl.
Yeah, and what's that you shoot like?
A champagne!
Man, stuck on himself, ain't you?
Not bad, I am. But as soon as I put old Betsy down here and try to gussy up to people, I'm about to knock his scrub up, ain't
I? I've seen worse than you.
That's the nicest thing I ever heard. Say, you wouldn't stay around here and look for him, would you?
Seems to me like it's that big phone head stiff gonna need all the luck.
Long as you're there, while all them people are looking at me, I'm gonna be looking for you.
Don't worry, honey. You'll find me. See you later.
Where are you going? Don't you like me?
I like you just fine. I just gotta go, that's all.
Guess I ain't exactly your type.
Look, honey, let's not...
So what is your type?
Well, you must know her. I like the girl who's, well, dainty, sees a mouse and faints.
I suppose I'm the kind that sees a mouse and a mouse.
Didn't say that.
Oh, my mother was frightened. Wonderful shot. I'd be out in the cat.
It's always a pleasure to return to my favorite state union.
Ohio.
I'm here to referee a contest of fence shooting between Frank Butler, the greatest sharpshooter on earth, and the best marksman your county has to offer. Is Mr. Butler's lieutenant present?
Is your sheriff here?
Sure is.
Annie! Somebody call the police!
Here she is, my sister.
Accepted our challenge.
You really, Buffalo Bill?
No one else.
I'm Annie Oakley.
I'm delighted, Miss Oakley.
You are?
Ladies and gentlemen, meet Mr. Frank Butler, charming assistant, Miss Dahl, let's say.
She's never gonna be satisfied just sitting there handing things.
Oh, yes, I would.
Have you ever been away from home before?
You mean I have to leave home?
We travel all over the country, Andy.
Have you ever been on a railroad train?
No.
You ever stayed in a hotel?
No.
Have you ever eaten a restaurant?
No.
Have you ever?
No. Do you know anything at all about show business? Show business? What's that?
Irish myself.
No fooling.
Don't let Dolly get you down, Tommy. Indians are real fine folks. It's the Irish I'm not too sure.
signed that Great Sioux Warrior.
I hear that Indian so ferocious he can slaughter a whole giant grizzly bear, Sanklin!
Harley Bill's been a bird under my cell ever since that bear stole my ship from right underneath me. He's nothing but a lying, thieving, mangy.
Bill, you bitch! Bam! It's great to see you!
Well, it is my best friend, old sidekick, Harley Bill. How the hell are you, old pirate?
You fellas know Chief Sentinel? Man who brought down General George Custer!
Never had the pleasure.
Huh! Ow! Is business.
So what can I do for you, old pal of mine?
I was hoping you'd extend to me the professional courtesy of letting me take a gander at that new phenom whose picture you plastered all over town.
You mean Aunt Evelyn? Well, I'd be delighted. Matt!
Yes, sir?
Take our distinguished guest to a private box.
Bye-bye, come along, Chief. All right, everyone, time to get ready for the show. Move it!
Good face.
Wait until you see her shoe.
You thinking of joining up with Bonnie Bell, Chief?
No. On my way home from Washington.
What were you doing down there, Chief?
Check the such a book. Went to see great white father about Indian territory.
They gave you a real hassle with that land, didn't they?
They ain't even farmer, can you?
Nothing will grow.
That's too bad.
Yes. Too much oil.
Oil? Boy, that's a tough break, Chief. What are you gonna do when you can't drink the oil?
Have to sell the oil. Sell 50,000 barrels a day.
50,000?
It's worth a try.
So tell me, Chief, what are you planning on doing with all that oil?
I'm planning to open gambling hall on my reservation.
All right, an idea, Chief, but for a relatively small amount, you could be a major actor bar while with you.
Chief sets a bull, live by three rules. Don't eat red meat. Don't get feet wet. And don't put money in shows.
How the hell did we ever get this country with you?
Charlie!
Yeah, it's Ruth Gaynor. You like it, right?
I like it. Wrong. Her picture is bigger than mine.
I figured you'd be pleased you're being stuck on her and all.
Stuck on her? Who said I was stuck on her? And even if I was stuck on her, which I ain't saying I am, I want to stay stuck on her, which I can't do unless I'm top dog. Any man would feel the same way, Charlie.
Well, this freak show head up the back.
They don't like Anna's poster.
You think we ought to go on with her big trick?
Autumn, we got them. If Andy don't draw a big business, we won't have enough dough to get out of town.
All right, I'll go see if everything's ready.
Charlie! I can't find Winnie. I've been looking everywhere for her, Charlie. Something's happened. I can feel it in my bones. And there's only one person around here low enough to corrupt a person sweet, innocent, almost as beautiful as I am. Baby sister.
I didn't do it. I swear.
Keep behind me. I just want to make sure the coast is clear.
That way I'll know who that person is.
Look out, St. Clair. Don't leave us here alone.
Quite alone now, honey. You got a husband.
Husband? Did I hear the word husband? Don't tell me you actually
over again.
Ain't got much time drawing after Rough Rider.
Thanks.
Annie, look!
What? What? You scared me half to death. It's only me.
It's me. Look, it's like I wanted to see it.
Isn't it exciting? Yesterday you were just calling to break up their guns.
They are the biggest stars you can.
Girls, to keep me safe from one.
I find it can't be done.
Annie Oakley, are you ready?
I sure am!
Then go!
like that.
Did you see Chief Sable? He actually bounced here twice.
I tell you, that girl's worth $1 million.
Just don't mention that particular figure from her. Ray, what are you doing? You're on in a minute.
Not him, I am. You expect me to go up there and one measly old horse after that slay of fireworks? What kind of fool do you take me for?
Now we all know why our picture was plastered all over town, and her pretending to be so innocent. Don't you go blaming Annie. She only wanted to surprise you.
Well, she sure did. And I bet the team you put her up to it, didn't you? There I was expecting her to shoot a little leg off the little dog's head when there she swooped out of the sky with the damn definition of firepower I ever saw. She got a full round lead fire at Gettysburg.
The little sneak, she's from playing you for a second, Frank.
Well, that's what I am, all right. I was crazy over that girl. Damn, I admit it. I was damn near ready to marry her, too. I thought she was sweet and simple. Simple, simple. In 2 weeks, I'm to be her sister. Cooking for her, too, I bet. Yeah, you can say that. In fact, you can say it was the biggest damn surprise of my whole life.
I knew you'd like it.
Where is Annie Oakley? Where is she?
Here she is, Chief. Annie, and Chief Sitting Bull.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Bull. This is my best friend. Soon to be my attendant, Mr. Frank Butler.
You in the show, too?
In the show? Why, he is the show. Frank's the star.
Star?
That means he's the best.
No, Annie Oakley is the best.
You like her, Chief?
Good girl.
Hear that, Annie? He wants to be your friend.
No, not friend. Chief Sitting Bull wants to make Annie Oakley his daughter. Give you Indian name. Watanya Cicilla. Little Short Shot. Here are teeth of many bears. And now, to help Doctor, Chief Sitting Bull will break lifelong rule. Put money in show business.
Did I hear you right, Chief?
Hear that, Annie? If you and Chief Sitting Bull back in our show, we'll go straight to New York, Madison Square Garden. We'll tour all over Europe. We'll perform in front of royalty. We'll make a fortune.
Come on, BB, we got a lot of plans to make. I never thought so much could happen all in one day. First I give me a new papa, and then I give me a new husband. Ain't that right, Frank? Frank? Where'd Frank go?
Here's a letter for you, Annie.
For me? Thanks. I ain't never had any letter before. Wonder who's it from? Frank? It's from Frank!
Daughter is the best friend.
That's right, Bobble. Say, can you read that?
Yes. Dear Annie.
What's the matter? Go on.
I'm leaving tonight to join Pawnee Little Show. I'm going to do my old act with Dolly.
What's he talking about?
You're a smart girl, Annie. Too smart for me. Good luck and goodbye.
What's he mean, too smart? Say, you sure you can read right?
No. I'm going to save it for one day when I can read it for myself.
Oh, Papa Bull, what am I
going to
do?
Never mind, Annie. You are still the best shot in the world.
Yeah. Right.
for the dealer.
$5.
Say more.
Red.
$5.
Uh-oh.
You don't actually expect me to believe you got that straight, do you? All right, a call. Hey, 310. What do you got?
4 8.
I thought you said you've never played poker before.
Buffalo Bill said it's easy to learn. Buffalo Bill was right.
I'm afraid we're all out of poo, Annie. You just have to wait till we land on New York.
Not there's New York! How come we can't land on it right now?
We'll wait until midnight so no one can see us make our drive in return on a cattle boat.
I'll give it to you in a nutshell, Annie. Our European tour was a big artistic success. But it cost a heap of money to travel a big troop like ours.
Heap. Since it's full, all has money.
But you had so much, Papa Bull. What about that third oil on the reservation?
No more oil. Rick, what father take it all for himself. He's some big Indian killer.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I didn't want to tell you, Annie. I didn't want to distract you while she's on the crown head. The thing about kings and queens are they give you medals instead of money. I'm afraid we're broke. We'll have to break up the show.
Break up the show? But you can't, Colonel Bill!
There's a launch port up alongside, and guess who's on it?
Unless it's John D. Rockefeller, I ain't interested.
Sure looks like Frank Butler.
Now I ain't interested!
Oh, come take a look, Annie. The low in the roof ladder now.
I don't want anything to do with him, Tommy. If he sets foot on this here boat, I'll go right down to my... Stop!
Stay and talk.
Talk? Yeah. Maybe I will. Sure, I'll talk to him. I'll say, what do you want around here, you big swollen-headed stick? And he'll say, I just need to talk to you, honey. And then I'll say, don't honey me. You thought I'd overcross you that I was trying to show you. I only did that trick to make you love me more. So why don't you love me more? Why'd you leave that away? Why didn't you cry? And that's when he'll say, because I was too ashamed. Besides, not riding won't be somebody don't love somebody. I'd be far hard out for you, honey. Can't eat, can't sleep. Then I reckon I'm gonna have to say, I ain't been sleeping a whole lot either, Frank. And then he'll say, oh, Annie, we both just gotta get some sleep. And then he'll add on, because he ain't through yet. Oh, Annie, I love you so. And I'll say, I love you too, Frank. And then there won't be nothing left for him to say except, Annie. And I'll just say, Frank, Frank. Hey! Frank!
No, but I sure wish I was.
What's the big idea? Taking you from Frank and kissing me that away!
And then the mayor didn't do anything.
Sure he did. He gave me an appetite I didn't want to get.
Colonel Cody, I've been in every ship in the harbor looking for you.
Who are you, son?
I phoned a message from Bonnie Bill. I'm looking in the show over at Madison Square Garden.
Bonnie Bill's playing in the garden?
Yeah, for 3 weeks now. Back in the into mostly society ladies. Princeton girls is falling in my gloves. Is Winnie Keeler at the show?
Winnie who?
Winnie Keeler, my wife.
Come on, Tommy, you know Dolly had that married, no?
Well, you mean Dolly's little sister, the cute little one? Yeah, she's at the show.
And long white gloves you mentioned. Any particular Frank Butler?
Who can you keep track? It's a message I wrote from Connie Bill. Tell me to wait for an answer.
Tommy, take this German blow. See if he can tell you more about Winnie.
Let me see that thing. Dear old Pat, welcome home, you scrawny old millionaire. How about if I threw you all a big reception tomorrow night at the Hotel Brimwood?
Got it.
Report. This town can't hardly wait to meet you all. Frank will be bringing his rich society ladies. White gloves.
Go on.
I won't take no for an answer. Your old pal, Bonnie Bill.
Well, your old pal beat us out again, BB. Our show's good for singing in town while his show's lousy and he's playing Madison Square Garden.
Charlie, what smart pal is, Buffalo Bill is good, but poor. Our show is lousy, but rich. Putting them together makes good average.
Yes, but you're a genius. We got the talent and they got the money. We'll merge the two shows.
What did you say, Roddy?
If the two shows could merge, then it would make it a little bit easier for me and Frank to do some merging of our own.
But what are Pontyville us good for?
Dolly's the only one I'm worried about. You saw Soap Pontyville, and I'm handy Dolly. And I got Frank, and I don't gotta wear no long black gloves either. I'll wear my low cut in the front dress. I'll show him a thing or two. And I'll wear all my medals, too. Come on, let's go sell that messenger the wild horse is gonna keep us away from that party tomorrow. Come on, Jake. Do you have anything?
No, I think I'll just sit here and spell. Think about how I'm gonna feel when he sees me. How I'm gonna feel when I see him.
Bye.
come to this little party of ours. Good evening.
Our host Major Pawnee Bill, accompanied by Miss Sylvia Potter Porter.
Well, if it isn't Miss Porter Potter Potter Porter.
How was close? What's that?
Mr. Frank Butler.
Bill, I don't know if this party was such a good idea. I'm worried to think that Annie might never speak to me again.
Forget about Annie, Frank.
It just so happens this party's our last chance.
What do you mean?
It's time you heard the truth, Frank. We're broke.
But I thought we were selling out of the gardens.
Right. And every time we take in a month, this little man with a badge and a big black bag walks in and scoops it up.
What do they call that?
New York City.
You're so broke, I killed this thing we need, Buffalo Bill.
We need Buffalo Bill, Frank.
Well, what do we need him for?
They're showing a fortune on their European tour. I'm trying to promote a merger.
That's terrific. Then me and Andy can pass things up.
Really, Frank, we're surprised. All she'll do is make a fool of you again.
I gotta go put on my medals.
Colonel William Babcock and Mr. Charles Davenport.
Anthony, this is my best friend, old sidekick, Pawnee Bill. How the hell are you, old pirate?
Billy, big bandit, it's great to see you.
Long time no see. Golly, how's it running out on your friend's business?
Well, I am just ravished to see you, Charlie.
You know, Bill, seeing you just gave me one hell of a crazy idea. You ever think what a terrific thing it'd be if we were to combine our two shows?
Combine?
Now that is a crazy idea, all right?
Dolly's right, Bill.
Well, of course I am.
But it might not be as crazy as it sounds.
Well, of course it is.
Come on, Bill, let's go somewhere we can have a real trip to top things.
No, wait!
I knew I'd put it over. How the hell did I do it? Mr. City Bull Chief of the Sioux Nation and his adopted daughter, Miss Annie Oakley.
Thank you.
got you that?
Satin and laces, just like you said.
And what's that you got spilled on you?
Uday, palad, nay, water. Like you said.
Pretty powerful stuff.
Better than gunpowder. And look, clean and straight on them, too. Like you said.
On the smoke, how you look?
Beats all hell, don't.
I'm going all goose flesh.
Do I dazzle you, friend?
Dazzle then some.
Am I driving you crazy?
Plum loco. I love you, Annie.
I love you back.
I didn't like living without you.
You talking.
You're the only girl in the whole world.
You talking.
I'm gonna marry you, Annie.
You can stop right there.
We'll have an old-fashioned wedding, blessed in the good old-fashioned way.
Attitude to start working again.
You can forget
get that notion, we ain't working together again or ever.
Not never.
Annie Oakley, you promised you'd back our show.
Let go, Bill. We don't need her. We've never needed her.
Can't just all of a sudden call a merger off.
Everything's off with this here match, Charlie. You'll have it arranged. You're all invited to the massacre.
Well, it would be pretty funny if we massacre you instead, wouldn't it?
Yeah, well, that's just one pleasure that you ain't gonna get, Miss Tate.
Well, we will just see about that.
That gesture fooled me. For a second, I thought it was wrapped around a lady.
If by lady you mean some really little ragdoll that'll lay down in front of you just so you can stomp all over her, sure as hell ain't me.
Hey, folks, see that?
Thank you.
using clay targets. 20 apiece, 5 at a time. The one with the fewest misses will be declared the winner.
Let's get started. I got me a date half an hour, which don't give me much time to beat her.
Beat me. Little Jay, give me that sack of gold medals I won for being the best shot in the entire world.
Annie, you don't need to...
What's the matter, Charlie? Afraid I'm going to lose?
Yes, I mean no.
Charlie, keep his mouth shut.
Here, Little Jay, you help the stats.
Careful, I'm heavy.
Now, just step up to the firing line. You can begin this contest.
You can begin it. I'm going to end it.
Is that so?
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. I'm going to show you a lesson in marksmanship he'll never forget.
You couldn't give me a lesson in long distance spin. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can't do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes,
anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that?
Sure.
So can a rat.
Anything of you can be, I can be higher.
I can sing any notes higher than you.
No, you can't. Here, honey.
Try mine for luck.
No, honey.
Did you just say money?
That's right, honey. I don't know what you were trying to do. What do you say we start over? Those first couple of misses, you were trying to give me a handicap, but I don't need it.
And I don't need no favors.
Everybody needs a favor. Sometimes, honey.
Thank you.
can't take me out of here.